It's my great pleasure now to introduce the Minister for Economy, Science and Transport. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Edwina Hart.
Well, thank you very much indeed. It's my pleasure to be with you this afternoon, but I understand I've actually missed a very exciting morning in terms of the discussions that have gone on and the ideas that have been there. I've certainly been impressed by the young person's manifesto that I've got in front of me, and I'm sure that my Deputy Minister for Skills will be delighted to be answering some of the questions posed within it, and I'm delighted that I don't have to do so. Can I say that Digital 14 is our flagship event for the ICT sector, and indeed the digital economy in Wales. I think it showcased the very best of Welsh companies and the digital talent, excellent research and development capabilities we have as a nation. And I think it's incredible to think that this is only the second event. Yet Digital 2014 has quickly become the biggest digital event in Wales, with an impressive list of internationally recognised speakers and around 1,000 people registered each day. We are certainly seeing growing interest in the benefits of digital technology from other sectors across Wales, including finance, tourism and the creative industries. This is further evidence of the cross-cutting nature of digital technologies that support all business in the digital economy. Growth and sustainable jobs are at the heart of our programme from government, and we made it clear that our absolute focus remains on supporting and boosting our economy and identifying every opportunity to help businesses in Wales. Of course, despite the economic downturn since 2008, this sector has grown by over 10% in the last 3 years, adding nearly 600 new businesses to the Welsh economy, which is a significant figure, most of them small and very innovative companies. I recall last year that Sir Terry Matthews challenged us not to be complacent and to make use of all the tools available to us to provide support to help to stimulate the economy and growth. That is why we continue to build upon the many good initiatives that exist in Wales, such as the Alacrity Foundation, which provides a graduate mentoring programme to commercialise technology and create a new breed of entrepreneurs emerging from our universities. In addition, EADS Foundation Wales is a £4.5 million programme funding research into secure mobile and wireless communications. We also have our high potential startup programme with funding of £3.4 million, 3-year project which actually commenced in 2012, which aims to increase the number of sustainable high growth indigenous businesses in Wales. And the early findings and analysis about this scheme have indicated that ICT companies have taken good advantage of this programme. We're also taking steps to improve our existing finance offering to business. We've introduced a micro-business loan fund, an SME investment fund, and of course the Wales Economic Growth Fund. And in addition, we've established a £20 million Wales Capital Growth Fund, which will allow SMEs to better manage the capital challenges caused by growing a business. Recently, I announced the Wales Technology Seed Fund, which will provide £7.5 million over 5 years to support early-stage businesses at the start of the commercialisation stage. It's aimed at startup technology, early-stage university spin-outs, and IP-rich companies looking to commercialise their innovative products and bring them to the market, providing, of course, you are in Wales and you intend to come to Wales. That is the condition on the fund. We've also as well acknowledged the recommendations of the Newport Business Development Task Force, led by Simon Gibson, about including the need to establish an innovation company as a focal point. A digital innovation company would enable us to showcase the diverse range of expertise and capability in the ICT and other key sectors in Wales and act as a catalyst for digital innovation, investment, collaboration and interaction between the private, public and education sectors. We are in advanced negotiations for the purchase of a suitable office space near Newport City Centre to accommodate the new company. And once secured, this will provide a high-quality infrastructure for digital businesses across all sectors in Wales. Jobs in the digital and ICT sector provide for attractive salaries when compared to other areas of the economy. It's therefore a puzzle to me that we're seeing a decline in the number of people leaving education with ICT disciplines. This is more concerning when you consider there are significant opportunities in the digital agenda that require these skills, such as improving our public services and delivering a world-class infrastructure and a vibrant economy. If we're to make ICT an attractive proposition for young people, it's clear we need to listen to our young learners. Why is it that some don't have the self-belief to become very important, I think, in terms of what they can do, is a question I think that is very worrying for us in government. But our overriding aim is to grow the sector through business support and growth. So it's a challenge to the industry and education, I believe, to get this sector right. We need to engage with and understand the career aspirations of young people. We must particularly do better about encouraging girls into digital disciplines, particularly if we want to meet the growing demand for trained IT professionals. And I know my Deputy Minister Ken Skates will deal with this later today. We're in a very competitive environment and we need to recognise that. It's very important that we recognise what assets we have in Wales, what we want to build up in Wales. We need to explore new opportunities for investing in our digital infrastructure. And I think it's very important that we recognise that a critical piece of infrastructure will transform the way in which businesses connect to the internet. And I hope to be able to say more about these plans when they're fully realised. Because we continue to explore new opportunities for investing in the digital infrastructure, and my officials are working with local telecoms industry and national organisations to develop ambitious plans to build an internet exchange in Wales. Now, I know you'll have a memorable event here. You'll have a lot of opportunities for engaging in dialogue. You've heard from some of high-caliber speakers, and I'm delighted that you've been able to attend this conference today, because I think it's important that we recognise what we have to offer in Wales, what Welsh companies have to offer, and it's also important to recognise the contribution that young people can make to the future of our economy. So I'll let you get on with your good work and far more interesting speakers than me. Thank you very much indeed.